turishimye cyane kandi turanezerewe. Tutangiye urugendo twabonaga bigoye, twarebe intekerezo dufite zo mu rugo twazibuza neza ahangaha, tukabona bitazashoboka. Nukuri natwe iyo dusenga tubasabira umugisha kugira ngo Imana yo mu ijuru ikomeze kubashyigikira kandi turindire umubyeyi.
If it's she's asking herself if it's Rwandans or Africans. For last like Rwandans, we have never knew that there is African people who can help. We used to know that white people, they are the one who can help. But for sure, it's amazing to us just to see the people who are like us, who have a skin like ours, who can even help. So it was like a miracle to us, because just we used to know that the white people are the ones who can help. Yeah.
Everybody pick their feet up off the ground. You know, get their shoes.
Yeah, because he definitely
Sorry.
Doing what they are doing, I will let you ask any of them their experiences so far and the benefits of what she has done. Maybe in your language. I don't think they can speak English. Okay, so maybe later on you will call one person to do that.
Hey, thank you very much for checking me out. This is Echo Simpson. If this is your first time of checking me out, kindly subscribe to this YouTube channel. You know, during my trip to Rwanda, Kigali, I happened to, chance on my mother, Mama One Africa. We've been, chilling and everything in Cape Coast, but we've brought it to Kigali. You know, there's this project she's, embarking on, which is very beautiful. Yeah, so I had to follow her to one of the villages to, do some donation and also check on the women she's, helping. You know, the whole thing is about elevating poverty from Africa. And she has started. And that is what I want you to know. I want you to follow. Ending of this month, there is something else you want to do, but I won't talk about that. I'll let her talk about the whole project herself. Thank you very much.
Two of our wonderful, wonderful instructors. And the purpose of our program is to economically empower women. Women who were victims of the Tutsi genocide. It's not me, but it's all of us trying to make a difference somewhere in the world. And for the 30 plus years that I spent in Ghana, I've now chosen to spend the balance of my time, and I don't know how long I'm gonna be here. I mean, I've been here 80 years already. I don't know how much longer I'm gonna be here, but I wanna be able to be here with these women because These women have so much promise for not only what they do for themselves, but what they will be doing for their community. And yes, at the end of the month, we do have a program going on, because these ladies have been working for the past 2 years, and they are better than the best in terms of the work that they produce. They are top-notch seamstresses, and there isn't anything that they have not been able to produce. So the help that we have, it's not big, but it's gone from small. You know, you start small, and then you get bigger, and you get bigger. And so I invite other brothers and sisters to be a part of the program that we have going here, which is the Gweru Economic Empowerment Initiative. They come and join us. Come to be a part of our growth and our development. Meet Mary. Mary has the Nyiramba Women's Center in Kigali. And she's one of our guardian angels. You know, some people just give, give, give. Well, she's one of them. She has inspired our group of 10 women.
Level of the Nyiramba Women's Center. So we are going to be that level of the Nyiramba Center here in Gweru.
My name is Marie-Aimée Umugeni. I'm from Nyiramba Women's Center, a women organization in Kigali who support women, especially those who didn't have a chance to go to school. So we start with teaching them how to read and write in our local language. And then we give them skills of sewing or hairdressing as skills that will help them to do something and earn an income. So I'm very happy to be here today at Gweru, where Mama Africa is starting an organization also to support women in this village. So we are very happy that Nyiramba Women's Center is able to go outside Kigali and help other women to become self-sustainable. So very happy to be here for the evaluation of that group. The group came to Nyiramba to get inspired, and we are happy that today they learned how to use a sewing machine, and now they are able to make their own clothes, they are able to make their children's clothes, and they are able to make to start a business from that skills. So thank you so much. I'm happy to be here today.
Mana. Yahaye ndashimira Imana yahaye abadamu bahawe uyu mubyeyi ni umuntu utangaje umuntu w'urukundo mbere na mbere ntabwo si ubumenyi gusa ahubwo kongera gusubiza abantu mu bumuntu n'abantu batagiriwe neza ntabwo natinya kubivuga bamwe barabishe imiryango yabo muri Jenoside urumva uwo muntu rero wakuze muri ubwo buzima ntabwo wamubwira ngo hari umuntu ugira neza ubaho hari abandi nkurikije ibiganiro nagiranye nabo ababyeyi babo bataye barababyara barabata barakomeza ubuzima urumva ni abantu rero bafite ibikomere bidashobora kugira ikintu kibivura ariko Imana yabahaye umuti mama ni umuti uvura ibikomere by'ababyeyi bari hano
Thank God that has brought Mama Africa here, and we are very happy for her, and we are very sure that we try our best to work hard so that she will be proud of her. She will be proud of us. So these ladies you have seen here, they are the ladies who have never got any person who can show them that he or she loves them.
So
these are the people who have grown up just to know the people who are learning after them, who just want to kill them. So they are the people who have never seen any love from any person. So they are very happy that they have seen someone who can show them that she loves them.
Kuko uko nyenda nahuye nabo bwa mbere naho bagereye aha ubona ko hari difference.
Yeah, so not only just helping them about the opportunity of suing, also she has just tried to show them the way they can be healed from all the past things they have made. So and that's healing, it's the one that they have used just to help them to get something that they are in today. There's the one she has tried just to talk with, and she asked them, she asked her, have you ever seen anyone who have given you a gift? And she said, in my life, no one have given me a gift. Yeah, so which means no one have tried just even to show the love to her. So it's her first time just to see someone who can show love to her. So there are some things you have brought. You see, you have brought the clothes for kids. This thing, it's not only just for getting those clothes, but mom is trying just to show them the way they can now try to know how they can even help others, even the community around them. So they will just start now to know how they can even start to help others or to give to others. So it's a lesson to them.
Yeah.
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 So it's like a seed which will help them, which help these ladies, just their kids, so that they can grow up knowing that there's someone who can love someone and then who can give a gift to someone though she didn't even seen that person or she didn't even know that person.
It's about family. It's about, you know, when I say one Africa, I mean exactly that we are one African people. And the more that we can come together as a collective, there's so much that we can get done. It's not about wars. It's not about hate. It's about loving one another. It's about helping one another. So that those who have can help those who don't have or have little, so that we can all flourish, that we all have something together. So I may be a blessing to them, but they're a blessing to me. They are truly a blessing to me. And I'm humbled by the fact that I'm able to not just do something on my own, but to get other people involved. So my objective is that anybody that comes to Rwanda, I'm bringing you all to my project. So come to my project, come to our project, and help us to make it better, bigger for our community of Gweru. All right? It's not like I came here and said, this is what you're going to do. When I came, I asked, what is it that you want to do? And let me help you to make that happen. So when I first came here, I came with Mama Zulu. I came with Byron Lifuk. I came with Sonia Lifuk, who came from Ghana here. And it's family. So I put it out to all of you who are there, whatever help you can give us, we greatly appreciate it. Not only that, we would appreciate, love it. Because that's what it is that we're about. We're about loving one another. And you know, I also get help from people on the other side that don't want to be, don't turn that camera over there on her.
Yeah.
She don't want her picture taken. But I will say this, that she has been more than helpful. She has been, if it's possible to be more than a sister. She's been all of those to all of that. She wears that hat of mother, sister, friend, confidant, and disciplinarian. Don't forget that. Okay.
Okay.
But she will put you in your place. Okay. And she gives good advice as she's giving good love.
If it's, she's asking herself if it's Rwandans or Africans. For us, like Rwandans, we have never knew that there is African people who can help. We used to know that white people, they're the one who can help. But for sure, it's amazing to us just to see the people who are like us, who have a skin like ours, who can even help. So it was like a miracle to us, because just we used to know that the white people are the ones who can help. Yeah.
Care center. Also, regarding our establishing a cooperative, of which Mary's going to help us to do that. We want to bring ourselves up to the level of the Nyamarambo Women's Center. So we are going to be that level of the Nyamarambo Center here in Gweru.